Hello, my name is Hannah, and I'm going to talk to you today a little bit about our ant farm kit. This really fun kit allows you to create an inanimate ant farm in your classroom so you can discuss a variety of things related to ant colonies without having to have an actual living ant colony in your classroom. What it consists of is 50 3D printed worker ants, 5 drones, and a single queen ant that you can then use in conjunction with found objects to create your own ant colony. What I've done here is take a large scale tray, filled it with just a little bit of sand, and then was able to use my finger to actually draw in different parts of the ant colonies. And then I used found objects such as rice for the eggs and the larva, navy beans for the pupa, lentils for the food source, and some dirt for the waste product. So some of the different rooms you might choose to build in your ant farm would be food storage areas, a room for the drones, and then of course low down in the ant colony you would find the queen's throne room, and then the egg hatchery, larva nursery, and pupa nursery, so you can watch the development of ants and so you can get a little bit into the infrastructure of an ant colony. And once you've done that, you have a really good chance to then discuss a lot of different things. In elementary school, you can simply look at drawing the ants and identifying the body parts. Or you can look at the lifestyle and diet of this organism. One of the most interesting things to do when looking at ant farms and ant colonies is how the social structure of an ant colony compares to other organisms, including humans. So at middle school and high school, you can compare the social structure of an ant colony and relate it to different social structures found within human societies. Additionally, this is a good chance for discussion of both non-native and invasive species. This all ties in to how both the environment affects how the ant colony itself works and is ordered, but also the impact the ant colony has on its environment. You can also talk about the human-environment interaction standards and cover those in your middle school and high school classes. So whether you're just building ant farms and creating all the different chambers within the ant colony, or if you are talking about diet, lifestyle, habitat, and the impact that these species have on their environment, we know you're going to have a blast with this inanimate ant farm that you can create right in your classroom. Thank you for listening. Have an amazing day.